because I wanted to. But no, okay, that would, I went too far with that. I went too far.
White, pinking, linking.
Hola, todos. ¿Cómo estás? Estoy muy bien. Look, I'm a little white because this is the best my makeup has looked in a minute. What am I doing today? I am going to be eating cheesy spicy ramen. I made a video about, and I have a story time. Just, yes, I have a story time. I tried to record this video before, just not with the story time, but just eating the ramen noodles, and my makeup looked so terrible. I bought a new foundation from the store, and it was way too dark, and it looked like I was doing blackface. I will show you that clip right now, so you can just see how bad it was.
You can already see the difference. You can see the difference. You can't see it.
Yeah, the real skin just looks bright as hell, that's all.
Look at this. Bitch. Bitch.
Okay.
Bitch.
Okay, so you see how I just could not upload that. No, that video was trash. And also, this noodles were too spicy for me. I put some butter in the hot sauce, so hopefully it's a little less spicy. And I think it's perfect for me to be doing this story time and this, like eating these noodles and telling a story time, because I'm gonna need to take breaks in between these noodles anyway. So let's get it popping. started making a particular friend who was like kind of like one of the centerfolds in this story. He was in the music department and we were in marching band together. We both became friends pretty quick because, number one, we were one of the only black motherfuckers that were in the music department and in marching band. So there was that. And two, we both hated marching band, like with a fiery passion, okay? And that's a lot. That's saying a lot when you're around people who just love that shit. You can't really complain about some shit that somebody else loves, you know what I mean? So. Thank you. She's so nice. There's no way I could ever, like, be mad. I can't be mad at this girl, like, whatever. Obviously, I can't be mad at someone for being in a relationship, but I'm saying, like, it's easier to hate someone when you, they have something that you want. But there's been instances in my life where I'm like, oh my god, this girl is great. Like, obviously, I'm not gonna be fake to her because I want your boyfriend, but she's nice. This girl was not nice. Like, she was, like, she knew how to, like, be cordial with someone. She knew how to, like, start up a conversation with someone. But when I, like, interacted with her and, like, overheard her talking to other people, she was just always complaining about everything. It was like, well, no wonder why your boyfriend thinks you don't have any fucking friends, because you're always complaining about some shit. And I would hear people talking shit about her, like, yeah, she's always in a bad mood, she's always this, she's always that, blah, 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 blah. So I was just like, nigga, leave that bitch and come my way, the fuck. But honestly, it really wasn't, like, it was disappointing to me, but I was like, all right, whatever. And I just put my feelings aside, because I was just like, he's really into this girl, and I don't want it to be like a thing where, because him and Cinnamon Bun hung out a lot, they were very good friends, and over the course of the year, Cinnamon Bun and White Cheddar started a band with my friend Simone and this other guy who we will name Swiffer, because I just, whatever, Swiffer, who played guitar, who was also in Merchie Band. And the thing about Swiffer is that was that he was very attractive. Swiffer was fine as hell, fine as fuck. Like, moment that I saw him, I was like, damn, nigga, you sexy. But whatever, it was like one of those things where it was like, I didn't never even anticipated him giving me the time of day, because so many girls were talking about how cute he was. Like, so many girls were, like, trying to get with him. And actually, for the first couple months that I even knew him, I thought that he didn't like me, because he would always be talking to Cinnamon Bun. And if I came up into the conversation, like, if I walked up to them and said hi, he would leave. So I was like, oh, he doesn't fucking like me. But then Cinnamon Bun later, like, told me, like, he's just really awkward and weird. So I was like, oh, okay, whatever. Anyway, so look, they start this band, and they started having open mic nights at our school, you know, to try to get people to come out to, like, sing and, like, do whatever. And they would host the open mic nights. Okay, so the closer that me and Cinnamon Bun got, the closer that I started hanging out with his people, which obviously meant that I was hanging out with White Cheddar a lot, which obviously meant that I was around Swiffer a lot. And at the time, Swiffer had a roommate that I had a huge crush on, who also played me, but it's okay, we'll call his jazz Cinnamon. So Cinnamon, and, oh wait, no, I can't call him Cinnamon, I already named my friend Cinnamon, but we'll call him Spinach. So Spinach and White, or no, Spinach and Swiffer, they were roommates together. Cinnamon Bun was roommates with this white guy, and then White Cheddar was roommates with someone else, I don't really know. Anyway, so it came out to be that Swiffer and what I named him Spinach, they would hang out a lot with me and my friend group. Like, they would, like, whenever they saw us sitting in the dining hall, we would always talk, and whenever in my group of girlfriends, we thought that they were cute as shit, so obviously we were entertaining that shit. I had the biggest crush on Spinach, and he would, like, flirt with me and stuff, and he would, like, playfully, like, kiss my cheek and whatever. And that happened over the course of a few months. So anyway, Halloween comes around, and the thing about it too was I was kind of like, I didn't have any hope in the situation because A, White Cheddar and his girlfriend had been together for a really long time, like almost a year, and whenever we were around, whenever I was around him, even though, you know, me and him would talk and we would have a really good conversation, he always brought up his girlfriend. Next awkward thing to the story. wasn't really trying to like get into it because obviously my interests are biased as fuck because I want to fuck your brains out. I'm going too far. But obviously my interests are biased. So I'm not going to be giving you my opinion about your situation when I know I wish your situation would be over. So I'm kind of in the corner just like popping a bottle, you feel me? Cinnamon bun and soy are the ones that I really like. But he wasn't really trying to go into it too much. He was just kind of like blown and like kind of like giving like an overall view of like the situation. Anyway, so it gets to the point where it's really late. And Cinnamon Bun, yo, when he's tired, he just falls the fuck out. So he was tired. He went on his bunk bed and because we were in Cinnamon Bun and Swiffer's room. So he went on top of his bunk on his bed and he falls. That nigga cocked out. He went to sleep. Cheddar had to go to the bathroom, so he goes to the bathroom. guess this prompted. We start walking and talking, and obviously our conversation just flows because that's just how we are when we're together. And we ended up talking outside, even though it was cold as shit. We started talking. We were talking for like an hour in the cold. And the bulk of the conversation, the first part of the conversation, it was just about, you know, us, like a general conversation that we just vibe well with. And then it turned into him going back to like talking about the problems that he was having with his girlfriend. And I really, when he started, because in the room, he, like I said, he wasn't really like going in deep, in depth, but he let it all out when we were alone. And like I've said before, you guys, I don't know why people just tell me everything when they're alone with me, but they do. I just have that effect on people. No, I'm kidding, but like dead ass. People just tell me shit. Like, so, he was telling me basically how he didn't feel appreciated by her, how much that he loved her so much, and he wished that she would show the same kind of affection, but she just wasn't an affectionate person. And how they were both busy, all that, so busy, but he would always go out of his way to make plans to hang out with her, and there were like plenty of times where she would cancel his plans last second to just hang out with her friends that she saw every day in the music department. But anyway, so it really hurt him, and he was just basically saying like, I feel like I love her so much, and I don't think she feels the same way about me. Like, I know she loves me, but I don't think she adores me like how I adore her. And bruh, when he was saying that, it really just, because that's exactly why my first relationship ended, because I could tell that I made him, my ex, my first ex, a priority in my life. He was number one, and he just did not view me the same way. And you know, we went, I planned everything, I paid for everything, I would do the most thoughtful shit for him. I took an 8-hour bus ride when we started being long distance. I took an 8-hour bus ride just to surprise him. He didn't appreciate none of that shit. So when he told me about everything and like how he does and like how he texts, how he shows her that he cares, I was just like, blown away, because I was like, we are literally the same person. We are literally the same person. And I was so mad because I was like, why is it that people like us always find themselves with people like that, who have trouble talking about their emotions, who have trouble connecting with people, who have attachment, like, who have, like, issues showing their affection? Like, I don't understand that. Like, why can't they link up with their motherfuckers and then we link up with people like us? Like, I don't get it. So it just really pissed me off because I was like, here is this great guy who deserves everything, in my opinion. Obviously, I had only known him for a few months, but from what I saw, we were so similar. It made me so mad that, like, we couldn't even see what it was between us. But anyway, so then he asked me, he's like, what do you think I should do? I don't know what to do. And bitch, I could have plotted. Oh my god. Because he was so fed up that it was to the point where he was thinking about breaking up with her. I could have fucking plotted, bitch. Oh my god. But I have such a sensitive conscience. I literally just could not do it. I could not do it. And even though I wanted him so bad, I told him the exact advice that I would tell a dear friend. But she was a friend of mine, so I gave the most objective advice that I could. And I told him, I was like, you need to tell her everything that you told me. You need to tell her that you're at your wit's end. out of my realm of people in general. So I'm sure you're wondering, well, bitch, if y'all stop talking, what the fuck's up with the title of the video? He cheated. Well, the story's not over, bitch. The story is not over. I have finished my ramen. And it is time for me to go to work. I will be finishing this story. So yeah, obviously there's more to the story. Namely, stick around for my heart getting broken. You gotta love that, obviously. My heart's gonna get stomped and smashed to the ground. Otherwise, what's the point of recording any of this? I'm here for you to laugh at my pain. So stay tuned.